So our focus now has been much more around creating personalized selling journeys for all of our brands and retailers. So part one of our journey was really to hook up all of the individual paths and channels. Now we are starting to see that once you've connected all of the online, offline channels, the apps, the marketplaces, you now have access to a lot more data. And you're seeing the efficiencies of this data coming through the pipes that we've built. The next step now has to be to make sense of this and to push it back to each channel to create sharper, smarter journeys. So for example, now that we have with our system, we're able to figure out what are customers buying across the site, the store, third-party marketplaces, MBOs offline. And then when you start bringing that data in and understanding, you know, what's the next thing a customer should buy, for example, we're able to make sense of that and then push it out to our channels. So for example, with our in-store clienteling product, a person at the store who greets you and is able to identify you, all of a sudden can tell you the five items in the store that you should definitely look at before you walk out. Previously, retail was a lot about, it was kind of a pull approach that you had to ask an assistant to help you. To pick a size or a style. Here, the store associate now knows exactly what to show you in that store based on all of your cross-channel data. So for the first time, we're able to now take data and push it out to each touch point to make your journey smarter as a consumer. So yes, AI, machine learning are at the core of this because the quantum of data being generated across channels requires more than humans to make gut decisions. And so using advanced analytics techniques, machine learning, cognitive sciences, we're able to collect this data and create the right propensity models, the right upsell, cross-sell models, and the self-learning models to ensure that not only are we pushing the right things to the customer in terms of recommendations, but we're also, for example, stocking the right things in our various channels from an inventory point of view that makes sense. So think of it this way. Someone like Charu, when she walks in the store, we'll know exactly what should be in the store for you rather than actually reacting to what you're trying to buy. So in both ways, both from a replenishment and from a recommendation point of view, we're using AI and machine learning to drive this data usage. So I don't think there's a distinction. The beauty of this is whatever you're building in the back end is exposed to all channels. So if for example, I'm using AI and machine learning to build a smarter propensity model, I plug that same model into all my channels. So the beauty of this is the underlying data structure, the underlying logic gets applied to all channels because as a brand or a retailer, my job is to then to ensure that every one of my touch points has a ubiquitous experience and my customers can find what they're looking for. So there's no distinction anymore. It really becomes around connecting sessions rather than thinking online only, offline only. We have a long list, so there's about 50 plus brands that we're working with. Brands who are here like Bata, Levi's, Arvind Group of Brands, we're working with Blackberry, we're working with tier two, tier three brands. In fashion, we're working with players like Soch, Pepe, Spiker, a lot of brands in the Indian landscape. What's more important is what are five experiences that will be very different for a consumer? So first on the list is seamless ordering, fulfillment, and customer service, which is still a struggle for a lot of retailers. So I'm going to put that in the hygiene bucket, which we should get better at. The second experience is around cross-channel journeys that are connected. So a lot of today of what we see is we're building stores and asking customers to come to us. What we have to do is to ensure our channels, from an experience point of view, reach our customers. So using digital, for example, at the top end of the purchase funnel to identify what you want, how much are you willing to pay, where will you go to get it? That's an experience that we'll do very quickly in the next 5 years, which is to take digital to the top end of the funnel to ensure that we create a Siri-like experience, where before you walk into a store or before you go to a site or before you open an app, we can tell you what's the right way to shop for what you're looking for. So that experience will be very different than what we do today, which is consumer scratches their head and they figure out where should I go to shop. So that's the second experience. The third experience is every point in our shopping journey will make logical sense. It'll make us feel like I've been in this store before. I have experienced this brand before. Today, a lot of our experiences are disparate and illogical because I might walk in the same store every year or every 3 months, but I still feel like I'm walking in there for the first time. The guy doesn't really know me. I don't really know what's in the store. So the third experience that will change is a lot of our experiences working with brands and retailers are going to feel like you're walking into your home. It's designed for you. It's catering to you. The fourth paradigm in terms of experiences is going to be around the ecosystem play. In the old world of industry and retail, we think of a microcosm, right? It's my customer, my channels, my product. The world is now changing where you have more ubiquitous customers. The words we keep using are, you know, the store of the future, the site of the future. The words we'll start using in the future really is the customer of the future. Because guess what? The customer who shops at your brand also uses Uber, also shops for food at a hypermarket. And so for the first time, we'll start seeing ubiquitous experiences, which is the same experience that you are experiencing with Uber should come to fashion because the same consumer. So the third real trend in experience is really going to be this idea that you have to be able to collaborate with other industries, with other networks, because network effects matter, right? Today, Uber has a huge customer base. If I can work with them and create a more of a seamless shopping experience, right? It creates a network effect for me. So you'll see larger collaborative network effects and experiences where you're looping together economies of scale across industries. So for example, in China, we see this with the super apps, right? The Alibaba network, which is different industries have started utilizing a common framework, which we'll see in India coming up in the next 5 years. And the last point is really around awareness, hyper awareness, which today we are lacking with is when we do, when we launch something new, or when we introduce something new in the market, our customers find out about it very late. The experience trend has to be one where we use digital in a smarter way to create better awareness before we even launch a product. Therefore, minimizing the issue we have today, which is 50% of our products are left unsold. So how do you create awareness and then build the entire system downstream based on awareness? That experience is going to change because you will feel like as a consumer that what's in a store is appropriate for you over time rather than some designer, you know, putting stuff in a store that you never want to buy. So all five of these trends are going to be the hyper trends, I think, of the next 5 years.